One, go. And we are live. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Atomic Punk, and welcome to the stream. And ladies and gentlemen, it is the final day of the year, the last day of 2020, December 31st. It has been a long, difficult year for pretty much everybody on the planet this year. 2020's been a rough one, but we're here at Smash Grounds to close it out, hopefully on a high note, because for this New Year's Eve, we got a special crew battle in the Smash Grounds Discord server, and it's going to be... Originally, it was planned as a 7-on-7, but it looks like it's probably going to end up being a 6-on-6, so we will just call it that. A 6-on-6 crew battle here tonight between Smash Grounds Black and Smash Grounds White. Just go with it. I did not have time to come up with clever names. And this is going to be the final Smash Grounds event that we have organized for the Smash Grounds Discord server. A bit of an impromptu one. This was something we literally talked about on the server yesterday to finally get ready to go. And hopefully we can actually get going here with this, and hopefully there won't be too many problems, and we can, again, like I said, we can end the year on a high note. Let me just see if I can center everything. Okay, scoreboard looks pretty good. They're going about the stage striking process, and they're actually using the stage striking channels left over from SGR11. Okay, that's interesting. We already got Turnip in here. Turnip is for representing Smash Grounds White to lead the charge, I believe. Yes, and before I go any further, allow me to introduce Super Smash Bailey, the return to the broadcast position. Probably isn't here right now, but you should expect to hear from her very shortly. There, you were a little incognito there.
Yeah. And yeah, my settings were pushed to talk by accident. Sorry about that, everybody.
Oh, so there you go. Super Smash Bailey is in the building, ladies and gentlemen.
It's good to be back.
We haven't commentated at least since sometime last year, but the band is back together. The duo is back.
Yep.
And as I said at the start, we're looking to see if we can end this year on a high note. 2020 was a rough one, but with this 6-on-6 crew battle, we can hopefully end it on a high note, at least for our server. This was originally scheduled to be a 7-on-7, but, you know, there are always those couple people who don't show up, so we had to strip it down to a 6-on-6. We should be getting started here soon. We got 10 viewers going by Streamlabs. Good stuff. Okay, and we're going to have Turnip leading off Team 2, which we will call on the stream Smash Grounds White. And it looks like it's going to be Kevling, or just Keb, leading off for Smash Grounds Black. Yes, black and white. Very clever. Didn't have time to come up with anything else.
I have no idea what fighters are going to come out of random here.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I believe I forgot to note that. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, for this crew battle, it is all random. So we don't know what characters each player is going to get. We don't know what matchups we're going to see. It's going to be a true test of game knowledge for both us announcers and for the players themselves.
Here we go.
And we are going to get started here. Here we go, and it's going to be Richter versus Isabel to begin things.
Oh, boy.
And as Nad79 once described it with the Belmonts, just press the B button. Although, yeah. Isabel does have the ability to pocket projectiles, so...
Yeah, like the axe and the cross. And the holy water, too.
So it's going to be a game of... Can Keb keep Turnip away from him, and can Turnip find a way to get him? Right now, he's definitely getting him right now. Got him up to 63%. And wow, big disadvantage in Keb. One big problem with the Belmonts, I almost said the Richters, the Belmonts, is that you don't want to end up too far off stage because their recovery definitely leaves a lot to be desired, but now this is where the Belmont wants to be. Get them off stage, get some distance, and try to set up shop, but Ken, expand Ken, that is Turnip, of course, is going to get in, and is he too far? No, he has his jump, able to make it back. So some early struggles here for Keb, but he's keeping it alive here. He does have a big percent deficit to deal with. Oh, but he catches it with the holy water! And Smash Ground's Black is going to draw first blood. And that is the power of the Belmonts. You build them up to the right percent, catch them in the holy water, and then the F smash, and that will take care of business. But the grab, is he at a high enough percentage? No, he's not. But he gets reeled in! Catch of the day! Still not enough, but the edge guard! Nice sequence there by Turnip.
And now we're 2 stops apiece now.
Keb did indeed end up being catch of the day on that stock. But I believe it looks like Turnip has pocketed a projectile. I'm not sure which one it was. We'll find out if he ever gets a chance to pull it out. Going for these grabs, though. Getting a little grab happy there. And eating up percent as a result. Oh, smart recovery, dropping low. And up tilt, into up air. That could have been the start of something, but Keb got out of it. And nice shield. Oh, but he walks right into an F smash, and this is not where you want to be against a Belmont.
And as you said that, he got 4 crowns again.
And it's as if the first stock was on repeat, getting it the exact same way as Keb. And SG White looking like they might go down. Remember, he pockets the axe. Will he get to do anything with it?
Nope. He just throws it away.
He says, get that garbage out of here. Okay, slowing down a little bit here. Okay. And Turnip might be in trouble here. Holy water! And for 3 straight stocks, it's the same setup.
Holy water to forward smash. 3 times.
Classic Belmont, and that is going to be the winning play for Smash Grounds Black. And thank you, Marsh, for hosting the stream.
I think Simon can do the same thing, right?
Okay, it looks like... Yeah. Okay, it looks like Smiley has actually shown up here, so... I'll tack on 3 to that, and... Okay, I gotta get... Okay, it looks like we got Smiley coming in, so Smiley will be coming in, after all, for Smash Grounds White, and for Smash Grounds Black, since Fiji is still MIA.
Yeah. But that was crazy that, he did... Holy water to forward smash 3 times. Again, that's a classic Belmont thing, like you said.
Okay, so Smiley's in, and I'm gonna see if I can get, I'm being told to turn Bailey up. I'll see if I can manage that. Sorry for the Windows noise there. The only way I can broadcast the VC is using the Windows speakers.
Can you hear me better, Atomic?
I don't think it's me that's having problems. It's the people watching. They're asking me to turn you up. I can hear you fine.
Oh, okay. Good.
I just want to make sure that I can get this right.
But that holy water force mask setup was insane.
And it looks like it's going to be Benster coming in next for SG White. So
we're probably not going to see a Richter this time, since it is random.
And so we did have to shuffle things a little bit. Smiley did ultimately manage to show up for SG White, so he's now on the team, and I think we're going to get Aaron Dyke to step in for Group 1, Smash Grounds Black, so we are at a 7-on-7 officially now, although now it's a 7-on-6 because Turnip has already been eliminated.
By the way, is Northern Cave legal now?
That's up to...
I mean, there's no hazards on them. There's no hazards on it.
I think if there's anything that's going to hold back Northern Cave, it's going to be the background.
Yeah, kind of like Final Destination, right?
Yeah, but I don't know. I think because... Especially towards the end of the animation where you have Meteor coming down, I think that there's concerns it might be a little too distracting. Yeah. There's so much spectacle on that stage.
Yeah, again, kind of like Final Destination. But hey, if people want to make Northern Cave legal for their tournaments, and more power to them.
So anyway, as a recap, we've had to update the score slightly. Originally, at the end of the last game, or rather the first game, it was Smash Grounds Black with 17 stocks left, and SG White with 15 stocks left. We've added 3 stocks to each total because... It seems like we are able to get 7 people on each team after all. And we're going to see who is Benster going to draw for his character. I'm going to laugh if he ends up getting Luigi. And if he does, Kev better be careful. Because it could be zero to death time.
Probably won't see Richter this time.
Okay, so one last thing I need to fix. Korn versus Cloud, alright.
Cloud with the Advent Children costume, specifically.
Alright, so... Fix one thing really quick here. I need to fix your name on the... thing, because you were actually going off the side of the screen. I didn't have it centered properly. There we go.
Benster sacrificed a stock or something.
I think we had a little bit of a miscommunication there. Benster SD'd when he didn't need to.
Yeah.
Keb had to SD over because he lost the stock previous game. It looks like we had a little bit of a... Looked like we had a little bit of a miscommunication there, so... Okay, it looks like we're gonna reset.
So we're not gonna see Korn versus Cloud, I guess.
Apparently not, so...
Yeah. Discussion. This is a restart.
We're not going to count that one. So. Okay, that was awkward, but we'll try this again. Okay, Benster, I don't want to call you out, but how do you not know that that's how that works?
Yeah, I mean, that's how it works.
I don't want to call someone out, especially when they can't defend themselves, but that's how crew battles work.
I mean, I played in the solitary murder crew battles, and I knew how to do it, I think.
Also, let me know, folks, about the audio levels if I need to turn up Bailey any further. I was told that I had to turn her up a few minutes earlier, but please let me know if I need to do so again. Oh. Okay, so it looks like what they're going to do is they're going to straight up select the characters that they were going to go.
Yeah.
So.
But this time, Cloud instead of Advent Children.
Okay, guys, how's that? I'm not sure how much higher I can raise Bailey's volume at the risk of hurting my ears here, but... Okay, so we're going to Smashville, and we're officially underway. Cloud versus Corrin. Keb with two stocks remaining because he lost one to Turnip in the first game. Smash Ground's black ahead, 20 stocks to 18. And Keb looking to see if he can build on that lead. Because that's the danger of these crew battles. They can start off close, but all it takes is one bad match for either team, and next thing you know, you're going to be in a hole. So Benster's got to see if he can stop the bleeding before it gets really bad.
And just earlier, Benster used Limit, and it didn't connect. And he's back on stage.
Climb Hazard his way back, but the percent is not on his side right now. Oh, he gets pinned, and that's gonna be the stock. He certainly got the point on that one. Oh, going for a counter, but he was never gonna hit you. He was behind you. That counter was never going to work.
Yeah.
Oh, falling forward air. Blade beam, not enough. Thing with Cloud is, when it comes to getting the kills, Cloud, it's a lot less about edgeguarding because of his less than optimal recovery. It's more about stage control and actually, you know, it's more about ledge trapping and stuff than going for actual edgeguards because, again, Cloud's recovery, not all that great, but the up B out of shield. And this percent is climbing very quickly. Already, Keb's got the lead.
He's still alive.
And trying to go for something fancy there with a counter at the ledge. He was never going to hit that, but I guess I respect the attempt trying to stop. Oh, the spot dodge. Up air, gonna take it. Okay, and...
Benster
has a chance to get the elimination, but... Going right into the cross slash. He didn't get all of it, but... Percent is percent. He can get something going. Oh, but he gets caught!
By that dragon bite.
Never look a gift horse in the mouth, and apparently don't look a dragon in the mouth either. And now, it's one stock apiece. Can Benster get SG White on the board, or is Keb gonna take another one? Keb looking like he has a chance to be the early MVP, although he's in trouble right now, able to make it back without using his up B. Oh, but he comes in.
Benster has Limit.
Oh, but he's caught. He might not get a chance to use it. He has to use it to recover. That is not what he was hoping for, and he's gonna get chomped.
And Keb is still in this.
And Keb takes another bite out of Smash Ground's White, and Smash Ground's Black sitting pretty right now. 19 to 15. And Kev, I don't think I've really seen him play before, but and granted, it is with just with randoms, but he's looking pretty good right now. And keep in mind, there's still seven other players to show up, or not seven, there's still six other people on SG Black. We still have Dark Drago, Nad, SK7, Poliwow, and JJ Gamerboy, and also I'm assuming Arundite, because Fiji was originally set to play for Smash Grounds Black, but he didn't respond to any pings, so someone else had to step in. And Smiley almost didn't make it for Smash Grounds White. Marsh, you're on Smash Grounds White. You're in Group 2. Please refer to the pinned posts in the Crew Battle discussion channel.
Really, Kev did really well with Richter and Corrin. Someone from SmackDown White has to step up.
I mean, we still have a few. We still have some good ones over on SG White. We still have Stram, Marco, Marsh, and Smiley, but not the best start for them. Benster and Turnip all both going down, and Kev is still hanging strong as the first member for Team Black. Now, if we can just get Marsh in here.
Yeah, Marsh is probably gonna step up, I guess.
Marsh and I had the pleasure of commentating together for the first time yesterday. We commentated a $5 first to five random money match between Nad and Cammy Whammy. Which Nad ultimately won 5-3. It almost went to the last game.
That money match was random, right?
All random.
Just like the Screw Battle. This one's all random too.
All else fails, go random.
Right?
And we're going to have to wait on Marsh for a little bit because Marsh has to take a little bathroom break. It is at this point where I would probably be plugging something, but there's nothing to plug. I haven't scheduled the next tournament yet or anything.
Yeah, there hasn't been any tournaments planned yet. Really, what a way to go out in the year with an all random crew battle, am I right?
Try to end this on some kind of high note.
Yep.
2020's been a rough year for the planet.
Yeah, with the pandemic and all that.
So let's try to put a smile on some people's faces here.
Crew battle.
And right now, if you're Smash Grounds Black, you gotta be smiling right now with Keb coming in here again. I think this is the first time I've seen Keb come in and play, and he has been doing work for his team. And Marsh wants to go Northern Cave, and he lays it out. If you say no, you're cringe. Will Keb be cringe or will he be goated? I Have I gotten the slang down right? Is that what all the kids are saying these days?
Yeah, you're doing good. You're doing good on that.
Insert obligatory boomer joke. I know I'm going to be seeing that in the stream chat within a couple minutes, probably.
Yeah, probably.
I can't help it. I'm a millennial.
All right.
Okay. I don't believe this is an actual... Okay.
Oh, this is button check.
I think they're going to taunt when they're actually ready, though. So I don't think they're going to leave out or anything. So I'm just going to do a quick button check. And we're going to get started with this game. And it looks like we're going to have Marsh... going with Captain Falcon, and Keb is going to be getting Wii Fit Trainer.
Oh boy.
And Keb, of course, is going to sacrifice his two stocks. And here we go! Now, the key thing here for... Oh, he already gets buried immediately right out of the gate. Anyway, the big thing here for Marsh is that he's got to get this kill without losing any of his stocks in return, because you're already down four stocks on SG White. SG Black with a pretty big lead right now. Not that big, but it could be big later on. Oh! F smash! Almost ending it just like that!
Ooh, he healed the down smash.
Wow, the down smash caused the lag spike right there. But now, it's Marsh who's... Oh! Nice up tilt! Going for the knee, not gonna get it. Oh, but backhands the soccer ball. Says, get that out of here. We're Americans. We play football, not soccer. Oh, but he's caught. Nobody gets out of the berry. And he knees the soccer ball. Okay.
Wow.
Oh, but Keb start. Oh, no. He's got deep breathing. This is bad.
Falcon kick. Nice.
Marsh cannot get touched right now. If Marsh gets touched, it's going to be bad. But the back air is gonna take it, so no harm done. I seriously, he was really in trouble when Keb got that deep breathing in. And finally, SG White get an elimination off SG Black. We're finally gonna see somebody else step in. But Keb definitely looking like the early MVP with those two early eliminations. And as I always like to note, Marsh did exactly what he needed to do, getting the stock without losing any of his own in return. So the margin is now SG Black with 18 stocks remaining and SG White with 15.
And Marsh wants to go Northern Cave always, I guess. I don't know.
And immediately someone else coming in for SG Black. We're going to get Poliwow. Poliwow has a bit of a reputation that precedes him. He's a bit of a... I shouldn't be saying this because of how I handled the game, but he's known for being a little bit of a salty person. When he lost his set, I forget who... when he lost his set to get eliminated a couple weeks ago at SGR 11, he actually... I guess the salt was so much he actually left the server briefly, but he did come back.
And I think they're about to start.
Although I think... Okay, they needed to be in the correct position, so Poliwow is actually supposed to be player one and Marsh is supposed to be player two.
Oh, yeah, so, yeah, yeah, yeah. Really well.
What the hell? Okay.
All right, here we go.
And so let's get it on. It's going to be another Belmont showing up for SG Black, and for SG White, we got Meta Knight for Marsh here, so... Meta Knight, definitely a far cry from his glory days in Brawl, but still can be a formidable character in the right hands.
Yeah, let's see if Poliwow can do what Keb did.
Let's see, can he do it with Richter is the question. He's got him off stage. It's gonna be a little harder with Meta Knight with the multi-jumps.
Yep.
So we're And so we're basically starting fresh with this one. Three stocks aside, although once again, SG Black is up by three stocks. But oh no, the recovery falling short. And that is gonna hurt. And just like that, the deficit is two stocks between the two teams. If Marsh can ride this momentum here. Gotta watch out for the cross, but he gets caught in the grab. And that's kind of what you're stuck in, the situation you're stuck in when you try to shield against a Belmont. You shield to protect yourself from the projectile, but they can just run in and grab. Oh, but he catches him landing with the down smash. Wonderful down smash coverage, but I think he's got... No, he's able to tether back. And yes, I know it's not like a true tether like Samus's grapple beam. I just call it tether because that's what it works like or looks like, so... Yeah. Oh, but he air dodges! Oh, unfortunate. Okay, so at the very worst, Marsh can end this game and make it a one-stock difference between the two teams. That's like, at the worst. If he can just keep on this... hold on to this stock... Okay, Marco's saying it is a tether. I don't know, I guess I was just thinking for some reason, because, you know, it's not like Samus's grapple beam or Young Link or Toon Link's grappling hook. I thought there would be a different term for it. Oh, he's got a chance. Oh, the spike, but he had his jump. Oh no, he doesn't have it now. That's it. No, he's still able to make it back. Poliwow hanging on tenaciously here. Trying to take at least one more stock before he gets taken out, potentially. Marsh, not able to get these edge guards. I don't know why he's not really trying to go out there. I mean, you got all these jumps with Meta Knight, and you have another stock to play with. I know stocks are a precious commodity in crew battles, but still. I think he could be going a lot more... I think he could be going a lot further with these edge guards. Honestly, this match should already be over by now, but it's still going, and Poliwow just missing the snipe with the axe, but again, this is where Belmont wants you to be.
And he forced him. One stock.
He forced him to jump over all those obstacles and was able to F smash him upon landing. Again, that's where Belmonts want you to be. Where you have no choice but to do a specific option that they'll be able to cover.
Belmont's projectiles are really dangerous in the right hand.
Oh, no way!
Wow.
Somebody clip that! What was that? Down air, up B? Clip that!
Probably was, I guess.
Good God! Poliwow waking up on that last stock!
Someone clipped that.
And that's a huge swing for SG Black. Even Marsh doesn't know what he did. Even Marsh is like, what? Wow, Poliwow. And again, Marsh definitely had multiple opportunities with his edge guards with Meta Knight, but just wasn't able to finish it.
But that was insane.
That was nuts. Send that to Yeet Smash someone. Like, at least we got a clip out of it.
Yeah, like down air, up B. I don't know if that's a true combo or what.
Somebody send that to Yeet Smash. Yeet Smash, where you at?
Yeah, I mean, that is insane. Poliwow to the Pog.
So let's see here. If I got my math correct, that is Benster, Turnip, and Marsh all down. I may have my math slightly wrong there. Let's see here. I have to do this on the air. Sorry, folks. I got to make sure, because now I'm all of a sudden I'm concerned that I don't have it. So Turnip went down. Then Fenster,
then Cab, and then Marsh.
And then Marsh.
Like, the white, Turnip, Fenster, and Marsh, and then black, Cab. Those are the only eliminated people so far.
Oh, wow, Poliwow again. Gotta give him... He definitely earned the wow part of his name.
Mm-hmm. I think Stromboli is in here, I think. I think that's who that is. Yeah, that's probably it.
Okay, I'm confident that I have my math correct. So the score should be something like 16 to 15. No, it's... Oh my god, I can't do math tonight! No, 4 times 3 is 12, and there are 4 players left. Okay, I don't know what's going on. All of a sudden, I can't do math.
It's fine.
So 16 to 12 is the score. It's a 4-stock difference. I think I got it right now.
And in the discussion channel, Marsh said he used to make this there. Go figure.
Okay, so hope... Oh, we got a Sonic!
Versus Wolf.
Okay, so I saw Stram running some Wolf earlier in friendlies, but let's see if he can apply any knowledge to... dealing with this Sonic here, if there's any saving grace, it is going to be the fact that Poliwow is down to his last stock, so... Similar situation to what Marsh was dealing with earlier against Keb. Can Stram take this last stock from Poliwow without losing any of his own in return to, at the least, make it 15 to 12?
We'll have to find out right here.
He's got the percent lead at the moment, and as soon as I say that, Sonic can erase that in a heartbeat.
Yeah, I mean, he's the fastest character in the game for a reason.
Fastest thing alive. Oh, but he eats a dash attack. Doesn't get the back air. That probably would have finished it. If there's one thing the Spaceys all have in common, their back airs are beefy. They hit hard. Very reliable kill moves if you can get the spacing and the timing and the setups. He gets out of the up smash! That should have been the kill!
He probably smashed the eye out of it.
Oh no. And that's how it ends. That was anticlimactic, but as Stram says, we take those.
And Poliwow said in his judging jail, in the Discord, he cannot play Sonic.
And Stram gets one on the board for SG White. It's still a 3-stock difference, but I've seen some crazy comebacks before in these crew battles. I cast my mind back to during the summer when we had the anime versus furries crew battle, where Ramen came in for Team Furry with his banjo and absolutely cleaned house. He was a big part of what led Team Furry to making a huge comeback in that crew battle. Who's gonna be the hero here? Because as it stands, we got Arondite coming in next for SG Black. Arondite coming in as a last-minute replacement for Fiji.
Yes. Fiji wasn't able to make it.
I guess Fiji started his partying a little early or something, so he didn't make it.
It made sense. It was just about New Year's. It makes sense.
And Arondite here. It's been a while since I've at least seen Arondite on my streams. I think the last time I saw Arondite in a stream may have been either a crew battle or the one I'm thinking about. It may have been I think it was Smash Grounds Rebirth 4, where he made top 8 for that tourney. Arundhide, of course, a former SGR champ. Smash Grounds Rebirth 2, he made a spectacular loser's run to the championship.
And he used Greninja back then, right?
Indeed. He said after the fact it was a week one Greninja, and he ran through everybody with it.
That's crazy. I'll be surprised if Arundhide gets Greninja from random. Here we go.
All right. So can Stram try to narrow this deficit here? And oh, we got Luigi versus Icy's. This is interesting. Okay, so I don't know if Arundhide knows how to get the Luigi Zero to death, and Stram better hope that he doesn't. Although hopefully maybe Icy's will make that a little harder, being two characters in one. Maybe he'll grab the wrong one. Who knows? Doing grabs against the Icy's, though, can be a risky proposition, especially if you grab the player-controlled one, because Nana can just knock you silly when you grab the player-controlled Icy,
yeah,
so...
Yeah, and this isn't melee, so wobbling isn't gonna play a part in this.
Yeah, there ain't no wobbling here. Oh, no, that's very unfortunate.
And Popo, I think, died, I think.
So, I believe that's Nana, who is the controlled player, so we got Sona instead of Sopo.
Yep.
The last thing you wanted to see happen, but then again, the AI for the second Icy, they're kinda dumb. So... Yeah, there's no wobbling. Well, he can't wobble anyway at this stage. There's no infinite chain grab.
And again, this isn't melee, so...
Oh! Back throw! Got him. Just like that. Yeah, I think Stram may have been dealt a bit of a bad hand here, but that's the price you pay when you go random.
Yeah.
Like I said, the AI-controlled Ice Climber can be a bit of a dum-dum, and that's what really hurt Stram on that first stock.
Yeah, but Hobo is back with Nana this time.
Can't get the Gimp, but nice sledge trapping here. Can he get the... Oh, he's not going to make it anyway! Too far away! Couldn't make it back. He was hoping for a misfire. His only chance would have been probably a misfire, so he still would have been able to use his jump and then the up B. He's a bit too far away at that point. And he runs right into the F smash. And able to make it back. So Stram gets on the board here, but it is now 14 stocks to 11. Gotta find a way to narrow this gap here. There's no chance of being able to tie it. That was best case scenario, but now...
Ooh, Nana just made it.
Wow, how does that happen?
Popo was back on stage, but Nana wasn't.
And this character pick, I mean, it's hard to call it a pick because he didn't intentionally pick Ice Climbers. It's safe to say that Stram definitely did not win the lottery here with this pick. Random definitely dealt him a bad hand here with Ice Climbers. It is not working right now. And Arundhide looking to make it 14-9 if he gets this elimination without losing his next stock. Oh, it's over! Got the stage spike. And that's it.
Yeah, I think Ice was a bad pick for him.
The game definitely... wanted to influence things there, giving, again, he got dealt a bad hand with that.
And I'd like to point out that Arundhide was using Luigi with the elegant skin there.
And now it's really starting to get away from SG White right now. SG Black with 14 stocks remaining to 9.
SG Black is... Still in this.
Big lead for SG Black. And now for SG White, it's down to Reaps and... Let's see, Reaps, Marco, and Smiley.
The question is, which one is gonna step up?
Not a lot of options between the two, between the three, but one of them's got to come in. Yep, there's no mercy rule here on Smash Grounds. You got to play to the very end.
Yeah,
there's no mercy rule in Smash.
Yeah, whether it's in a tournament or a free battle or whatever the case may be. There's no mercy around here.
Stocks to 9. This is starting to get one-sided now, although it's kind of been one-sided from the beginning, especially with Keb getting such a hot start for SG Black. But wow, they just, every time it looks like SG White has a chance to narrow the gap, something just happens that allows SG Black to pull it off. I mean, you just got to look at, I think the big game to look at is the one between Marsh and Poliwow, where Poliwow, for all intents and purposes, stole that game to eliminate Marsh.
Yeah. I think Miley wants to go. I don't know.
He's being called upon, so it looks like it's going to be Smiley to have to step in.
And yes, Smiley's gonna step in.
And we're gonna see Smiley.
Victors from random tonight.
Definitely a lot of Belmont representation, that's for sure. Both Belmonts coming out the winning end.
Yeah. I will be really surprised if we see a third Richter or Belmont come out from random.
And we got Smiley.
Yep.
So unfortunately for Smiley, since it's random, he's not going to be able to pull out his fox for this one. He's got to do it the hard way with whatever the game gives him.
I'll be pleasantly surprised if Fox comes out from his side. Oh my god.
Okay, so...
Alright. Let's see who we got.
And it is gonna be... Rosalina versus Bayonetta.
Oh,
oh no. Oh no, I don't think this is... This is going to be very interesting to try to call. Bayonetta did actually get some buffs in a recent patch, I believe, but... We'll see what that does. Let's see if Smiley knows what to do here with this character. Do not sleep on Bayo.
Yeah, she'll combo you in a heartbeat.
It's all about... She might not be who she was in Smash 4, but... If the Bayo knows what they're doing and you don't know what you're doing, like, you can still be in trouble if you don't know how to actually deal with this character.
Yeah.
I mean, that's Captain Obvious commentary, but still.
Yeah, that's fair. And specifically, Smiley's going with the Bayonetta 2 alt there.
Okay, let's see. Can he... No! Oh! Shield. Either he dropped the shield, got a slight shield poke. Not gonna get him with the giant fist. No SpongeBob reference coming. And... Okay. Smiley.
And I feel like he's using Bayo 1, not Bayo 2. My bad.
And... Shields coming out from Arendyne, protecting him from these approaches. Oh, and then comes a giant fist, but it's not gonna kill. Not gonna get the stomp either, but that is gonna clean it up. I think that was a back air there.
Yep, it was a back air.
And finally, oh, but as I'm just about to say, Smiley finally gets the kill. There's Arendyne to catch him on the platform with the up smash. And Arendyne takes a stock, but he's down to his last one. Can Smiley just try to... If you're SG White at this point, you just need to see... You just need to find some kind of momentum here. You're now trailing 13 stocks to 8. You could potentially be down to 2 people left if Smiley can't get it done here.
Yeah, I mean,
you gotta find... Gotta find some kind of momentum.
Yeah, but this is Bayonetta we're talking about here. Anything can happen.
I don't know. If this were Smash 4 Bayonetta, I'd feel a little more optimistic about Smiley's chances here. Then again, I think we can all be thankful that we'll probably never see anything like Smash 4 Bayo again. Probably no character, at least in Smash, was more detrimental to the competitive meta than Smash 4 Bayo was. Oh, and there's an edgeguard coming out from Arendyne.
Man, Arendyne just upbeat off stage.
And Arendyne takes himself out. That had to be a missed input or something. Something went wrong. Something went very wrong there. And despite getting the kill, Arendyne takes himself out, but the damage has been done. Smiley is down to his last stock, and the score is now 12-7. I didn't even see what happened. I just looked back at the screen, and all of a sudden, Arendyne was dead. I saw a game pop up on the screen. I was like, what happened?
And Arendyne said in the New Year's discussion channel, he didn't reverse it.
I guess that's what he was going for.
Yeah. But who's gonna step in for SG Black?
Still sitting on a comfortable lead here, 12-7, but if I've learned one thing from my years of watching football, no lead is safe.
You got that right.
What? And Marco is saying, save us, Smiley. And Smiley says, I'll be able to save you when the game decides to give me Fox, Falco, Falcon, or Mario. That's 4 out of 80. I don't like those odds, Smiley.
Yeah, 4 in 80 chance.
I'm not sure about those odds, Smiley. You know, it looks like we're gonna get SK7 coming in for SG Black.
SG7 might come in.
Okay, SK7. Now, SK7's got a pretty... I've seen him make a few top 8 placements in a few recent tourneys I've commentated. He's got a pretty nasty Steve. And I think my opinion of Steve is well documented, but we'll see what he can do with random.
SK7's an I don't mind what stage, just not Kalos. Smiley also wants Ike. Good luck for that. Ready? And here we go.
Joker versus Kirby.
Joker and Kirby. I'm not so sure about how this is probably gonna go. Smiley is gonna have to sacrifice 2 stocks, so that is gonna work in the favor of SK7. Not that SK7 needs that much help. His team is coming in with a 5 stock lead.
But this ought to be interesting. Joker versus Kirby.
I don't know. Smiley's got to be careful here. I've seen what Kirby can do here. I've seen those quick kills with getting them off stage and then getting down air for the drill. So.
And I guess being top tier is not always cracked up to be.
Smiley's got to watch it here. Although he's getting that meter built up. Oh, going for the hammer? No, it's not hammer time just yet.
Yeah, Smiley is nearly getting our stand.
SK7 just trying to get into some kind of position here to get advantage, but Smiley not giving it to him. He catches him coming in, but Arsene is out, and this could be trouble. This is where, if Smiley wants to get anything going, this is the time to do it. Now you got Arsene. You're not going to have too many chances to get him, especially with 1 stock left. So... not getting anything out of him right now at the moment. He's gonna get... oh, he went for the sucking cuck. He tried to walk off stage with him in his mouth.
And Arsene is gone.
And that's Smiley not able to get any mileage out of Arsene. When you get Arsene, especially in this situation, you have to make him count. Smiley not able to get it done. Gonna get the falling back air. And SK7 is now at the nice percent. The funny number, as Nad likes to call it.
Not anymore.
Nad should know a thing or two about the funny number. After all, Fiji's nickname for Nad is Rad69. Oh, and he's gonna catch him with the up smash! And it is 12-6, and SG White, they're down to 2 players left. So we're down to 2 players left for SG White. We still have Reaps and Marco. They're the only ones left. Meanwhile, if either of them can somehow eliminate SK7, you're still going to see JJ Gamerboy, Nad, and potentially Dark Drago. I believe Dark Drago is busy right now in another crew battle.
And Reaper is about to come in.
Wow, and Smiley with the, I won't call it a hot take, but This is what happens when you don't give your loyalty to every S tier like everyone else in the community. Damn. Marco's saying he wants Drago to go in. I don't think Drago might not even be available for this one. At least for a while, because he said earlier he's anchoring a crew battle on his crew, Bowser's Minions. And we got Reaps coming in for SG White. They're running out of hope here. They might not have... They need a miracle right now. Because it is 12 stocks to 6, ladies and gentlemen.
Two players left in white. I don't know, if SK7 keeps this up, he might be the MVP for SG Black.
Okay, here we go. Or perhaps not.
Reaper's asking if he's left or right. He's on the right side. SK7 on the left, Reaper on the right.
Oh good, they actually kept track of where they're supposed to be, because the last couple games, I think I had to actually swap the players. And here we go, so... Oh no, not this matchup again!
Oh my goodness. Luigi versus Icy's again?
Twice in a row, we somehow... What are the odds? Getting the same matchup twice out of a random Ditto, but it is what it is. Let's see if Reaps has a bit of a better grasp on Icy's and can get it done here against SK7. This is... You gotta play the cards that you've been dealt, and this is the hand that Reaps has been dealt. Gotta get it done with Icy's.
And SK7 with Luigi.
Oh! I don't know if he was short anyway, or if that ice block actually had some kind of influence there, but either way, SK7 not able to make it back, just short. You know what, I'm gonna stick with my story, it was the ice block got him.
Yeah.
I'm gonna give credit to Reaps for that, that's the story I'm sticking with. Don't try to contradict me.
I mean, the ice block... Probably had a wing bot or something.
Either way, SK7 goes down a stock, and that's going to make it 11-6 at the current moment. But SK7 going for the Cyclone, trying to catch them. Not going to let him get the grab. Oh, but he gets through with the dash attack. Ooh, hard read there going for the grab. Oh, but he catches him. And is he going to get him again? Oh, this time he's able to make it. He's able to fall down and get the ledge. I think Magnet Hands helped him out there. Oh, and he misses it! And that's a punish! And that is the power... Well, sometimes the power of Luigi works against him. Because that up B, you miss the... You get the sour spot or you just straight up miss it. You are just wide open.
But SK7 got a stop, so.
We're looking at 10-5 now, excuse me. Not gonna get anything on the down smash, trying to cover a getup, perhaps. Oh, and he got him again, and that's it! SK7 is out, and there's still some life left in SG White. It's still a 4-stock game, 9-5, but there is still some life left in them.
Both teams are at single digits now.
And it looks like Nad is going to come in for SG Black. Reaper able to get it done with Icy's. SG Black still with a lead. They've never trailed this entire crew battle. It's definitely been, they've dominated good portions of this. And it looks like Nad could be the one to possibly come in and finish things off if he can take care of Reaper real quick. And I guess for the occasion, it's Rad 69 for tonight.
Yeah, for New Year's, I guess. Yeah, you can follow Rad 69 on the Discord and in the game.
Fiji, where are you at? Probably getting drunk somewhere with his buddies or something.
Yeah. It's kind of embarrassing. People getting ready for New Year's do that sometimes. Alright. For the love of God, don't show us Luigi and Icy's again. Oh boy.
And here we go with the score. 9 stocks to 5. SG Black still in control. Shulk versus Kirby.
We're seeing a Kirby again.
Now this is the matchup that ended. This is the matchup that ended the 1-to-5 money match between Cammy and Nad yesterday. Nad got Kirby, Cammy got Shulk, and it went down to last stock, and it looked like Cammy had a chance to force a decisive game 9, but Nad was able to finish the job and win that money match 5-to-3. So same matchup as last time, but this time it's Nad getting Shulk and Reaps getting Kirby. And I can already see it in the chat. This matchup is terrible for Kirby, so Reaps, you got your work cut out for you. And Nat, of course, is no slouch ever since he first joined Smash Grounds. And ever since he first joined Smash Grounds. Oh, but Reaps! Okay, there's some life. He's not going to go down without a fight. Good edgeguard there with the neutral air. There's a chance. There's a chance. And Reaps at Nad's percent. Not anymore. So like I said, Nad is no slouch ever since he first joined Smash Grounds. When he's competed for Smash Grounds Rebirth, he has almost consistently placed in top 8s. Although he's had a couple down performances in a couple of the tourneys. And Ramen is already suggesting that Reaps go for the sucking cuck.
I don't know if he might.
He went for it. He actually went for it. Oh, is he gonna get back thrown? No, it's not enough. Okay. Nad, don't get too close to the edge. He's retreating from the ledge. Very smart in case he does go for it. But Reaps, he's gotta get off the ledge. He's losing his invincibility because he re-grabbed. Oh, but he gets caught by the landing aerial. And this is probably, is Reaps down to his last stock, or can he take another one to narrow the gap a little bit further? The current score is now, oh, good grab. But he's got Buster Art, and oh, he gets up through the smash. Gives him the power bomb. It's not enough. Okay. And Reaps. Oh, he gets knocked out of the stone, trying to catch him with the down B, almost like Bowser. little bit of a trade there. Back throw coming. No, down throw. Perhaps he wasn't confident in the back throw, but the back air's gonna get it. Okay, so Reap's trying to hang on here, but it's 62%. Gotta be careful here. A few more hits could get him a kill percent. And with this spacing from Nad, it's gonna be a challenge to get in. But he does get in. Okay, that's a start. Another grab. A quick 52. Okay, that's a start.
That was a good string. But Smash Art is out.
Oh yeah, if he gets touched, this is going to be over. Big clutch shield right there. Smash Art has run out, but still. Okay, he got him. He tripped him with the down tilt into a dash attack. Gonna get... No, he doesn't! He got the tech! He's still going! Reap's fighting for his life! Oh, for his team!
Oh my goodness. Yeah.
Doesn't get the F smash. A grab. Back throw. And... Oh no. Oh, he went for the drill. Didn't get him.
Oh boy.
Okay, Reap's has really got to be careful here. One mistake, a bad approach is going to end it. One bad approach into a punish is going to end it here. And
eater player here.
Reap's. Look at them. They don't want to approach. They're so... They are playing with such nerves right now.
They're so afraid.
Oh! The dash attack! It's not enough! Oh, but he's short! He's short! And Reap survives!
Incredible.
Reap's isn't done yet!
And Adam had a valiant effort with Shulk.
What was that? Dude, that last neutral leading up to the end, they were so scared. They were just going back and forth. Neither of them wanted to be the one to make the first move and make a mistake. But Reap's got through with the dash attack. And Nad was not able to make it back.
Yeah, the only arts Nad used were Buster and Smash.
Yeah, he even said it himself, he doesn't know how to use Shulk.
Hey, I don't either.
Now you get a Shulk who knows how to actually use the arts. They can be a Shulk player who knows how to use the arts is a scary opponent.
Yeah.
Like we still have Evil's Bane around on Smash Grounds. He doesn't appear nearly as much as he used to, but his Shulk can be. I'm sure his Shulk is scary now. I understand he has improved.
Indeed, and I wonder if he's gonna come up next for Smash SG Black.
So this is as close as the crew battle's been for quite a while. It's 6-4. Well, who's gonna come in next for SG Black? It's either gonna be JJ Gamerboy or it's gonna be Dark Drago. It'll probably have to be JJ Gamerboy because
Dark Drago's busy with his crew, I guess.
I don't know. Okay, we got... Okay, JJ is going in.
I think JJ's a newcomer, I think.
No, he's been around. He's been in a couple tournaments. He's just not the most active person.
Understandable.
I don't believe I've ever actually seen him play.
And there he is.
So we might have a crew battle on... We might, as they say, we might have a real match. We just got a real match.
Evo 2007, I think?
Yep. Justin Wong versus Yipes. Yeah, Marvel 2.
We got a real match.
Okay, so again, once again, quick recap. The score right now is SG Black ahead over SG White 6-4. Again, this is the closest the crew battle has been for quite a while. At one point, the score was as many as 12-6, but Reap's showing some heart. And granted, of course, you know, we do have the caveat that these are random battles, but still, the scoreboard doesn't lie.
And here we go.
And we got Diddy Kong versus Piranha Plant.
The Plant versus Diddy.
Alright, so Reeps, of course, is going to take two stocks off. And on one stock with Piranha Plant, he's got to get past JJ Gamer Boy coming in fresh with Diddy Kong to try to keep hope alive for SG White. Now, of course, Marco is still waiting in the wings, but let's see if Reeps can, at the very least, soften up JJ in order for, in case Reeps can't get it done here. He's got him at a good percent here, but JJ does get in, gonna get the up air. Gonna catch him landing. And... whoo! That was a risk. That was a very risky getup, but... oh, that's actually gonna kill!
That's surprising.
I'm surprised that actually killed. And so, Reeps... still doing work. Reeps, if Reeps can pull this back, without a doubt, he will be the MVP. An unlikely MVP. But an MVP nonetheless. JJ trying to get something going. He gets him with the side B. That's a command grab. You can't shield grabs anyway, but that is a command grab. Gets him again, and now Reeps could be in trouble here. JJ not gonna go for the edge guard, gonna stay on stage. And Reeps just gotta try to reset neutral, regain advantage. Gets a grab, nice grab. Oh, the Patooie! That's it! He's done!
Oh my goodness.
Reeps! It's 4-4! Reeps has brought it all the way back! But he's at 130%! Oh, and he was able to get him off.
Reeps might do it. I don't know.
Can Reeps actually get it done here? JJ, just gotta see if he can get something going here. Can he get anything? Not that time. Not gonna get the F smash. Gonna get a grab. Oh no! Patooie again! Oh, he just gets over the smash, but he gets grabbed!
Oh my goodness.
Some actual excitement going down here. Is Reeps going to take it? If he takes this stock, SG White will have come all the way back to take the lead. What a way to end 2020! And Reeps!
Oh my goodness, Reeps.
Reeps has brought them all the way back!
With Piranha Plant.
SG White! What a comeback! I know it's not over yet. It's not over yet. We gotta calm down a little bit. But Reeps is gonna be, regardless of how this comes out, Reeps is going to be the MVP for his team.
But again, we gotta cool down a little bit. Because we have one more person in SG White waiting. If we...
Reeps, this kid really is goated.
So SG Black has one man down and one man left.
All right, Dark Drago, whatever you're busy with, you better be done right now because you gotta come in. This is insanity. I don't care if it's randoms.
First we had a down double down air up B with Richter. Then Reeves brought it back.
Again, I want to point this out. I want to emphasize. At one point, it was 12-6 in favor of SG Black. But Reeves for SG White has brought it all the way back. And now Dark Drago is the last man standing for SG Black. If SG Black want to avoid this epic collapse, Dark Drago's the one who's got to do it.
Yeah, I think at the end of this, Reese might be the MVP.
Nine stocks. This kid putting in the work. The Booty Goons, well represented here tonight by Reaps. The Booty Goons, the crew that Stramboli formed, which Reaps is a member of. The Booty Goons got a lot to be proud of right now.
I didn't think Reaps would bring that back. Jesus.
The Booty Goons have a lot to be proud of right now with their boy.
And here we go.
Could this be the last game?
Sephiroth
versus Reaps with Zelda. Oh.
Oh my god.
And we're on Yoshi's Story.
Zelda versus Sephiroth. This ought to be an interesting one.
Alright, is Dark Drago gonna give Reaps despair? Or is Reaps gonna somehow finish it?
Okay.
Let's see if Drago can just finish it off right here. I mean, we are on Yoshi's, which has, if I'm correct, the smallest blast zones of all the legal stages. And with the reach of Sephiroth.
Nice
Octa Slash. Giga Flare. Just gonna miss. And Drago, well, pretty much a lot of us have been putting in some work with Sephiroth. But yeah, Drago's been doing some work with Sephiroth. He does know how to actually use the character. But Reaps has him facing a percent deficit, but there's that range again. Oh, Giga Flare! Yes, it's enough! Wow, that was sudden. And that looked like some good DI there. He almost lived it.
And this is the final round of the crew battle.
Alright, I never thought we'd see this. It wasn't looking like this was gonna happen a few minutes ago until Reaps went beast mode. But we're going to the last game.
The last game of the end of year 2020 crew battle.
The final event, the final Smash Grounds event for 2020 is gonna go down to the last game of this crew battle. What a way for us to cap off what has been a very rough year. Not just for Smash, but pretty much for the planet in general.
Yeah.
And here we go. It's going to be Dark Drago versus Marco. And Marco specifically wanted to be on the opposite team from Dark Drago. Well, I hope it's not a case of be careful what you wish for, because it's going to be Marco versus Drago to finish this.
To cap off 2020. And for the random side, I did not expect Sephiroth to show up of all that. And he was just, like, added, like, what, like, a few days ago?
So, and they're begging. SG White is begging Marco not to throw.
Yeah, Marsh is saying, be good at the game for once.
Okay, Ramen, the points you're listing about 2020 being a good year, some of them I find highly debatable.
Well, what do you say?
Okay, so if we can just get Marco in here.
If we knew this would, again, this would be the last game. We're about the last game. I did not expect Sephiroth to show up, and He was added a few days ago, I think. Yeah, I think a few days ago. But, yeah.
So here we go. Who's gonna end their 2020 on a high note, at least here on Smash Grounds? Again, I never could have anticipated that this is how we were gonna end. Again, earlier in this stream, the score was 12-6, and it looked like SG Black were in the driver's seat, but Reaps coming in for SG White and being the hero. The hero they needed. I'm not sure if it was the hero they deserved, but...
And Marco has arrived.
Alright, Marco, you wanted this. You wanted to fight Drago. I hope this isn't a case of be careful what you wish for. Because you just got it.
Like you said, someone will end 2020 on a high note here. You want a gentleman to random or something? I don't know. On the Discord chat.
And once again, sorry if you heard a notification from Windows just now. I plugged in my phone because my phone needs charging.
That's fair.
Ow! My ears! Once again, I can't directly stream the voice chat through Streamlabs. I have to stream it through Windows speakers.
They want gentlemen to Palu's temple. Imagine.
Pretty sure gentlemaning goes against the spirit of randomness, but whatever, I'll allow it.
Yeah, hey, more power to him, I guess.
Marco very adamant that he wants to go gentleman to Palu's temple, so okay.
Yeah, I'll allow it too. Why not? Again, more power to him. Drago wants to know if what happens if we go time.
Huh. All right, guys, can we just get this going? Can we just go? Let's move it along here. Alright, we're going to Palu's. I'm not sure how this is gonna pan out.
JJ said, this is the epic final battle we've been waiting for.
So they're debating about what happens if they go to time. Let's hope it doesn't come to that.
Yeah.
If we spend a whole 7 minutes on Palu's temple, I'm gonna ban everybody.
I mean, I didn't expect they'd do it like this. Jesus.
All right, here we go. This is
final battle.
a final battle we never thought we'd see, and it's gonna be Samus versus Ness.
At Powers.
Oh god, this is going to be the most toxic game of Smash you will ever see on Smash Grounds.
And they both have fresh stops now, I guess.
Guys, don't do this. Don't do this. Don't do this. Actually play, please.
I didn't expect it to be like this.
Don't do this. Come on now. I'm about to tell them both in the Discord, play or I will ban you. None of this stalling nonsense. I just laid it down for both of them in the Discord. Actually fight each other, or you're both getting banned.
You heard him, guys.
Okay, they actually hit each other. Okay, can we get a fight here? So anyway, Marco's starting off with the early percent advantage. Oh, nope, not gonna get him with the up smash. Samus is up smash. Not good. Oh no! The degenerate online Ness with the PK fire. Oh! Down air? But the platform's there to help him. He wasn't at kill percent anyway, not even close. And
Margaret's taunting.
Yeah, I'm already regretting allowing them to go here. I should have said no, pick a legal stage. And Drago not gonna get anything off that down air, trying to catch him with the charge shot, not gonna happen. I guess they're just gonna keep fighting down here. It's like fighting on Temple in Melee. You just fight down in the cave and everybody just bounces off the ceiling like a pinball. So if they're going to be fighting down here, I expect both to ultimately live to ludicrously high percents, unless, of course, Marco absorbs the charge shot, which he does. And Drago going to try to approach. Yes, he is, but he gets caught by down smash. Going to be sent flying. Oh! Oh, the platform helps him again. He hits the underside. We got this stage over Pokéfloat, says Ramen. I would have preferred Pokéfloats. At least with Pokéfloats, there's auto-scrolling and stuff, so ultimately, at some point, you're forced to move and stuff. I would have gladly taken Pokéfloats over this.
Yeah, if they brought it back, that is.
Alright, so, and this match is already, we're under 4 minutes in, and a stock has not been taken. You know what, I'm about to just say, if this match goes to time, we're not even going to count it. We're going to force these two to restart and play a legal stage. And after this, I don't know, I might ban both of them anyway. Why did you guys want to do this?
It was their decisions, I guess.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to ban everybody. I'm just gonna ban everybody and we'll just rebuild the server from scratch. What is this? Trying to just run away. I mean, I wouldn't blame him. He's at over 200% and if Marco so much as touches him. This is quality Smash content. This is why I stream, folks.
No shots have been taken yet.
And Drago continues to run away. We're under 2 minutes to go here. And they're fighting on the lowest platform, and still not enough. The geography of the stage saves Drago again. We are under 2 minutes to play in this game. This is definitely going to time. Oh my goodness, he bounces off the ceiling repeatedly like he got spiked like a volleyball. And they still... Oh my god, guys. Is this really happening right now? Trying to catch him with Psy Magnet, not gonna happen there. And throws him into the ceiling. Still not enough to kill him. At some point, someone's gotta die here, right?
And 60 seconds left.
Well, this was a wonderful waste of 7 minutes of our time. Okay, you know what? As soon as this match ends, I don't see either of them dying before this is over. We're not going to count this game. We're gonna redo this, and we're gonna do it on a real stage. We are not going to count this. Because this is absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah, no. We're not gonna count this if someone doesn't die in the next 15 seconds.
Alright, 15 seconds. You're on a timer. Come on, Drago just going to continue to run away. And no, we are not going to judge this by tournaments or anything. So no, just because of the percent, we're not going to give it to Drago. We're not counting this sudden death.
We're not going to count that one.
Okay. No, we're not letting them switch fighters. It's all random. We're wiping that game from the canon. That match does not count. It is non-canon. Do not acknowledge it.
Yeah, we're not going to talk about that one.
Ramen, when have you heard of someone doing a 7-minute button check? Get out of here with that. You want to get banned? Don't make me go low tier god on you here. Get that ass banned.
Oh no. Yeah, I'm gonna solve the free between Mark and Dragon.
Okay, so all right.
Okay, fine.
So after 10 minutes of nothing, we're actually going to get something going for real here, and it's going to be Roy versus Palu, and we're going to Pokemon Stadium 2, so we're going to end this hopefully with an actual fight. None of those shenanigans that we were seeing, so... So, picking up where we left off, Smash Grounds Black once had a lead over Smash Grounds White by a score of 12-6, but Reaps for SG White brought it all the way back to make it 4 stocks to 3, and then Reaps got eliminated by... Crap, I've already forgotten everything. Dang it, it's... Wow, my memory... I've had some memory loss right now, but... Reaps finally ultimately got eliminated. Marco then came in. And then... Dark Drago has come in for SGR Black. So... We're down to the last two players here. It's 3 stocks apiece between the two teams. Someone is winning and someone is losing. This is the game to decide everything. And again, earlier tonight, we didn't think we were ever going to get to this point. Marco with the advantage now, trying to catch him with up smash with Palu. Can't get it. Big shield there. And double edge dance gonna take it.
SG Black is in the lead now.
And Dark Drago has SG Black 2 stocks away from surviving what could be an epic collapse after the run that Reaps went on for Team White. Just gonna get the pummel.
Only for Drago to break out.
Nice parry there. Oh, good roll away from the up smash. And can't get the up air after the throw. And Drago trying to see if he can bring Marco down to 1 stock. Another double edge dance. Not going to kill him this time. You'll be surprised at the percents that that can kill at. Back throw? Why are you pummeling? Back throw him! He's got to be well past the threshold where back throw will kill. Okay. Forward throw? Not enough. And Marco, gonna dare him to approach. He gets the back throw this time, and yes. And here we go, it's 2 stocks apiece. 2 stocks left for both teams, but Marco, if he's not careful, Drago is going to potentially bring it down quickly here, over 100% now on Marco. Marco gotta get some extra credit here at the very least. And here come the Nairs, only able to get a couple. Classic Palutena, although he only got a couple out of it. Oh, and the double edge dance again! And SG White might be down to their last stock. This is it! Is Drago gonna be the one to finish the job after, once again, a few matches earlier tonight, SG Black had what looked like a comfortable lead, 12 stocks to 6. And then Reaps went on that run for White to bring it all the way back. Drago trying to make sure that SG Black does not have a total collapse here. He's at the funny number right now. Oh, good catch, dropping the shield and catching it with a down smash. Oh, and a big whiff on the counter there by Marco. You don't want to be just throwing out counter, and the up smash is going to do it. And at the funny number, Dark Drago is going to hold off SG White and SG Black. After what looked like it was going to be an epic collapse, they're going to hang on to win thanks to the efforts of Dark Drago. And that is going to end the random New Year's Eve crew battle for the Smash Grounds Discord. And it's SG Black getting it done with 2 stocks remaining. Finally, finishing off SG White. And that is gonna do it. So I guess we're just gonna go ahead and end it right here. So that is gonna do it for this stream. That is the end of this crew battle. Once again, SG Black takes it over SG White with 2 stocks remaining. Reaps, a valiant effort on his part for SG White, getting them in position to potentially complete the comeback. But in the end, Dark Drago is able to seal the victory for SG Black. They are the winners. And that is it. The final event of Smash Grounds for the year of 2020 has concluded. And where I live, here on the East Coast, we're just a couple hours away from the new year. And here's hoping 2021 will be better than 2020.
Yeah. And it's four hours left where I live.
And that is going to do it. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is it for this stream. That is it for the crew battle for Super Smash Bailey. I am the Atomic Punk signing out for now. And I hope to see you folks again soon as we start the new year.